With certain exceptions, there are three types of ATGM-equipped vehicles in the game. The first type are vehicles with ATGMs on external racks. The second type are the ones that can fire both ATGMs and live rounds from their guns or launchers. The third type is rather special. It consists of machines that rely on ATGMs as their main means of dealing damage. They are a very different kind of beast, so today we'll speak only about the first two types. There aren't that many vehicles of the first type. Let's see, the French AMX 13 SS-11 and the AMX 13 HOT. The German Begleitpanzer 57, the Soviet BMP-1, and the British STRV-81. It's worth mentioning that the AMX, the STRV, and the BMP carry first-generation ATGMs. The main difference between the first and second generation of guided missiles lies in their guidance system. In the case of the simpler ATGMs, you have to stop and guide the missile manually with movement keys. That's not easy. That's where we see mistake number one. You aren't prepared enough. It takes just a couple of hours at the test drive to get a hang of it and learn how to consistently hit targets even with the first generation ATGMs. Just a couple of hours. But you have to do it, and it's well worth the effort. ATGMs appear at BR 6.7, where they can destroy almost anything with a single hit. Mistake number two. You're too stingy with your missiles. It's hard to underestimate their value, as you only usually get between 3 and 6 of them, depending on your vehicle, and every shot has to count. But, and that's a very big but, on the battlefield, there are many situations where you might consider just shooting off a missile or two at no particular target. Why? ATGM racks make you very, very vulnerable. Yeah, it's not easy to hit them at a considerable distance. But if that happens, there's a big chance you'll go straight to the hangar. And don't even think about engaging enemies in CQC if you still carry a few missiles. In the second category, you get a slightly bigger roster. The Soviet T-62M1, the T-64B, the American M551, the M60A2, and the XM-803, as well as the MTB-70 and the German KPZ-70. As we move into higher tiers, there comes mistake number three. You pick the wrong targets. The game changes a lot at high BR. Forget about the time when you could one-shot anything in your sights. Now, many of your opponents come outfitted with composite armor, or ERA, or both. This means that most of the time you won't be able to penetrate their defenses. Be reasonable. In most cases, you'd get better results with an APFSDS. It has a faster travel rate and better penetration rates, flat. Does this mean that ATGMs are worthless at high ranks? Nope. First of all, there are still many targets for you to hunt. SPAAGs, light tanks, and SPGs are your bread and butter. Furthermore, ATGMs allow you to hit moving or small targets. Hey, there's a tank moving in the distance. Fire an ATGM. There's a target behind a hill. Fire an ATGM. There's an aircraft flying by. You get the idea. Just remember, your missile is much slower than a conventional shell, and you have to guide it till the moment you hit a target. While you're controlling the missile, you won't be able to move from your firing position, so make sure you're in a safe place.